Image-to-image allows you to adapt upon any existing image with a diffusion model. This video will walk you through the steps on how to do this within ComfyUI. Let's take a look. Okay, so I have a blank ComfyUI workspace here, so I'm going to go ahead and add the necessary nodes. So first off, I'm going to go ahead and get the checkpoint loader, and then I'm going to use this default dream shaper. I'm going to load an image, so we will have an image that we will take into the diffusion model. I'm going to load up the K sampler. And so this will go ahead and sample the image and then go ahead and adapt upon it. And I'm going to go ahead and add in our prompts. So the positive and the negative prompts here. We'll go ahead and connect that here. And then we'll get the negative prompt as well too. All right, so this is a basic setup here. So what we need to do though is we need to actually encode this image into the latent space before we can adapt upon it. So in order to do that, we need to put in a latent image. So we will actually go ahead and put in a VAE encode. So we'll go ahead and take that here, and then we'll use the VAE of the checkpoint into this encoder. So then this will go ahead and adapt this image so we can go ahead and run it through the diffusion model here. So I go ahead and connect this to the latent image. So now I'm gonna go ahead and set up my prompt. I'm gonna go ahead and copy over the original prompt for this image that I created. And say, for instance, I wanted to change this person from 45 to 85 years old. So I'm gonna go ahead and basically use this model to go ahead and do this, and it's going to use this image as a initial source for the latent space here. Now, as far as the denoise, this goes on a scale from 0 to 1, so basically if we leave it at 1, it's going to be a completely new image and won't really know much about this original image, which kind of defeats the purpose of what we would want for image to image for, whereas if we set it to 0, the image would have no changes whatsoever. So what we're going to do is going to set this to about the 0.6 on a value here. So it's going to add noise to it and then denoise it with this modified prompt that we have here. So I'm going to go ahead and put in a VAE decode now. So we're basically encoding this. Now we're going to go ahead and decode it so we can see the image again. And so I'm going to connect that noodle there, and then I'm going to go ahead and connect this to the original models so we can see the image. And I'm going to go ahead and put preview image, and then connect these two together. So just to recap here is we have our original source image, we're encoding it into the latent space, and then connecting it to this case sampler. We can use our original prompt that described this image and make some sort of adaptations upon it, such as the age or whether or not the subject had glasses, where they might have been standing, whether it was Antarctica or, say, for instance, some sort of city, or, of course, the negative prompt as well, too. So now whenever I cue this prompt and let it go through the steps here, we can see with the green outlines that we'll see now how we changed the image from a person that was 45 years old, roughly, to a person that is 85 years old. So that is image to image within ComfyUI, and you can use the same process for the Stable Diffusion XL models as well too. And so yes, I hope that you found this video helpful. If you have any questions, please drop a line in the comment section below. And of course, if you liked or are interested in the channel, please consider hitting the thumbs up and also subscribing. Thank you so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next one. Take care.